anniversary of Bluegrass Hometown Roots Music Studies at ETSU this year. And if you'll put it on your calendars, Friday night, October 21st, at the Martin Center for the Arts. I see everybody going down, getting their papers, write it down. Put that in your purse, tucked away, put it in your phone. We're going to have a big night at the new Martin Center for the Arts with a lot of people that you recognize. Randy McLean will be there, Jack Todd will be there from Hawaii, and some celebrities, some alumni from the 1980s and 90s and early 2000s. And of course, ETSU Bluegrass Prime, and some surprises that I can't tell you about. So you'll want to be there. And you can go to the Carter Family Fold the next night. So we want to stay off of Saturday.
Let's give a warm Carter Family Fold welcome to the ETSU Bluegrass.
Thank you. y'all. But don't go away. I need more Philippines later this evening. So, you know, we love how our dancers are here, and we know that y'all love to dance, so don't go away. But this next one we have, this comes from a singer-songwriter that goes by the name of John Lilly. He's out of West Virginia. He's a good friend of my mom's, and they've done a lot of projects together.
You've been, you have 1 year, year and a half, right? Just one, okay. And Stephen, he plays all the instruments. He's like a lot of these folks on the stage. They play all sorts of instruments and can do a lot. But we met on Thursday and said, we need about 800 fiddle tunes for the Carter Family Fold. Because if you all remember, Jeanette Carter used to sit back here on the pew and she would tug on the fiddler's pant leg and say, hey, play a fiddle tune about every third number. So we're going to try to do that tonight. But I'd like to introduce a former student. And I'm going to have to raise this microphone up. He's a former fellow. He was in the Bluegrass Old Time Roots Music Program about 12, 13 years ago. If you would, he's going to sing one tonight with us. This is Mark Carter. Make him feel good.
Well, the rose ain't the
could do a couple of gospel numbers. Our bass player. This is his second year in the ETSU Bluegrass Prime Band. His folks are here tonight doing a live stream on the way over the night. He's going to get a little busy on this song. I always tell him. I tell him to get a little busy on this because I like how he does that. This is Will Pox back here on the bass. On the guitar over here, he plays in a gospel group called the King James Boys. Now, I hear the next group that you're planning to join is the New International Version. Is that the NIV Boys? That sounds like a medical thing, the NIV Boys. NIV, yeah, the IV Boys. A lot of our students, they play professionally in groups, and it's always a challenge for me whenever people are in the Bluegrass Choir Band for a year or two, and then they say, oh, Dan, I can't play with you anymore because Lux River Band called me, and they won't get going with another group anymore. Doyle Lawson called, Rhonda Vincent called, and I got to go play for her, and I say, well, I could fail you, keep you here a little longer, but you're doing a good job balancing both. The other night you were in, we played it at Rhythm and Roots in Bristol, and then you had to drive all the way to, where was that at? Tell
me. We played Bristol Rhythm and Roots at 4, I believe. We played 4 to 5, and I had to play the event I was playing at in Columbus, North Carolina. I actually started at 5 o'clock, and it's 2 hours away. So luckily, my band, the King James, was playing a little bit later, then around 7, so I moved in right in time, and I would say I didn't speed, but I had a ticket to prove it.
Well, you can't be perfect with everything, I guess, but I'm glad you got there safely. This is Will Hart. Please make a note.
Thank you.
got another dance team for you. We got three in a row. You can start with some salad. That sounds good.